Cuban visit, assessing wildfires in California. I'm Ann Cates. Pope Francis has met with the Castro family and held an outdoor mass for thousands in Havana today, where he celebrated the people of Cuba.
It is a people which has its wounds, like every other people, yet knows how to stand up with open arms, to keep walking in hope, because it has a vocation of grandeur.
Some of the residents evacuated because of massive wildfires in Northern California are being allowed to return home, but life is not back to normal yet. Correspondent Cherokee Shams is in Middletown, California.
We've seen PG&E crews out today, heavy equipment trucks working. In some neighborhoods, there are even power lines down. So the sheriff's department says even without flames and without smoke, it's still not safe in some areas to go back home.
A new wildfire has broken out in Monterey County, killing one person and destroying 10 homes there. S&P futures sliding down 2 points. The NASDAQ futures off 6. I'm Ann Cates. A new CNN ORC poll shows some movement at the top of the Republican presidential field following the GOP debate. Correspondent Sunland Ashfati.
The question posed was, regardless of who you support, which candidate do you think did the best job in this debate? Very telling results here. Carly Fiorina overwhelmingly seen as the best. She was followed by Marco Rubio, Donald Trump, Chris Christie. Of course, he managed to really interject at key moments during the course of that debate.
Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton says Donald Trump is fueling paranoia and prejudice against all kinds of people. And in an appearance today on CBS's Face the Nation, Clinton once again addressed the email controversy stemming from her tenure as Secretary of State.
I'm sorry that I made a choice that has raised all of these questions, because I don't like reading, you know, the people have questions about what I did and how I did it. I'm proud of the work we did at the State Department.
And Clinton says she'll present a new plan this week to control the cost of prescription drugs. I'm Ann Cates.
Hi, I'm Joan London. When I needed to find senior care for my mom, I really struggled to find the right fit until I found an advisor, someone who had been through this before. That's why I recommend A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. They have experts who will help you ask the right questions and find the right place. Call A Place for Mom today.
To speak with a local senior living advisor, call A Place for Mom at 1-800-467-7530. That's 1-800-467-7530.
A Place for Mom has helped over 200,000 families find the right senior care for their parents, from assisted living to independent living, even Alzheimer's care, and have local advisors that can help explain your options at no cost to you.
To speak with a local senior living advisor, call A Place for Mom at 1-800-467-7530. That's 1-800-467-7530.
Call today.
A group of McDonald's shareholders is once again calling on the fast food giant to buy meat from animals raised without antibiotics. Correspondent Scott Carr.
The use of antibiotics by veterinarians is legal, but as the number of human infections increase from antibiotic-resistant bacteria dubbed superbugs, consumer advocates and public health experts have become more critical of the practice of routinely feeding antibiotics to chicken, cattle, and pigs. McDonald's shareholder, the Congregation of Benedictine Sisters of Texas, withdrew a similar resolution in March after the chain announced it would phase out chicken produced with antibiotics. Now they say they want such rules for the whole barnyard. I'm Scott Carr.
The United Nations World Food Program is running short on cash to help feed the largest flood of refugees in recorded history, and today has debuted a new fundraising and awareness campaign backed by the donated advertising firepower of brands like McDonald's and Google. Other companies taking part in the hunger relief effort include MasterCard and Facebook. I'm Ann Cates.
What would an extra $250 a month mean to you? For some,
hands are shaking so badly now. I'm so scared.
Girl. Madison, 101.5 FM.
Let her go.